First of all, congratulations on this incredible run with Power.
Thank you.
These are some of the most devious characters ever put on television.
Absolutely.
Which character on Power do you think would make the best NHL owner?
I think Joe would. Tommy.
The best NHL owner, hands down, would be Councilman Rashad Tate, the character that I play. Why? Because he has an agenda, he's always focused, and he's trying to elevate things.
Councilman Tate, I think he would be the best, because you gotta have that finesse, you gotta have that drive, and the best player would be Mike Dopin, who plays Jason Mitchich on the show, because he's from Canada, so he kicks ass in hockey.
Ghost, James St. Patrick, because he'd get everybody working, doing their thing.
I would say Simon Stern. I actually know a few NHL owners, and he seems like one.
Probably Ghost. Ghost is probably the best owner of anything, but NHL player is Tommy. I mean, absolutely bar none, Tommy would be great on the ice.
I think the combination of Courtney Kemp and 50 Cent together, you know, Courtney would have the visionary, she would set the plays, and then 50 can really teach you how to crack heads.
So if there was a Stanley Cup party at Truth, what's that party look like?
All right, I know how you hockey boys get down. You're ferocious. So there would be a ton of champagne. There'd be so much champagne, there'd be at least 3 to 6 inches of champagne on the floor of Truth. I think there would be tons of people dancing. I think clothing would be optional. It'd be a good time for all.
You had to learn to skate for that Onyx video. What type of appreciation do you have for what NHL players have to do on a daily basis?
It's tough. It's not one of those things that you just get up one morning and decide to do. It requires multiple skill sets. You know, you got to get comfortable on them skates and everything else too. That's what that video, I ended up going into the penalty box to perform, and that video was easier.
Let's talk about you playing hockey.
I was a bit of a grinder, rough and tough winger, and yeah, ended up playing in the East Coast Hockey League, played junior hockey in Quebec.
You were in the Blackhawks locker room,
yes,
right after they won the cup.
Showing the loves, it brings the cities together, brings people together, no matter what your background is.
So we just launched an incredible series with Wyclef Jean, and he's talking about diversity and inclusion in hockey and in sports. When you look at how hip hop has really intersected with different types of sports,
right,
what would you like to see from the hip hop community in the hockey community?
Well, I mean, the hockey players are listening to hip hop. It's integrating in lifestyle. You know, just getting more people involved.
I'd like to see some of the 80s bands, the 80s like groups, like Run DMC, EPMD, they'd have to all group up and play the Wu-Tang Clan, see how they did.
I mean, just more of, you know, black folk, you know, people of color. Hockey is something that can be for everybody. Anything when it comes to hip hop or the culture, we make stuff kind of fly. You make it very fly. And it's, I'm not saying that the NHL is not fly, but you gotta put a little more sauce on it. You know what I mean? You put a little bit more sauce on it, it'll be fly, it'll be dope.
The sports teach you leadership, teamwork, camaraderie, and how to win championships.
We have to have people of all races in hockey. And you know what's happening? I see it in Canada, and I do see a lot more, even where I'm from. There's a lot more African-American players. There's also Iranian, I know there's two Iranian kids that play. Playing hockey is such a team sport that I think it's important, and the guys get together and all for one goal, and that's to win.
There wasn't a whole lot of ice skating rings around my neighborhood. There's always a basketball court, a football field, baseball.
We're also celebrating our first African-American player. His name is Willie O'Ree. In any sport, when you're a youngster and you get to see someone like that breaking barriers, what kind of impact does that have on a young child?
Oh, a tremendous impact, because it says that no matter what is in front of you, you can continue to ascend to the highest of the high. It encourages and inspires anybody that may have things that are against them. So to see that this man has been able to do this is beautiful.